Here we go again.
Last night, Manchester United defender Luke Shaw has released a statement after suffering a small injury setback. After making a return from injury in November's Premier League draw at Ipswich Town, Luke played in subsequent victories against Bodo Glimt and Everton, both at Old Trafford. On Tuesday evening, he posted the following statement on social media. "Hi guys, it's hurting a lot having to write this as I really thought I had got through my recent struggles and was on a positive path going forward. But unfortunately, I've had a small setback. I've been through a lot and had a lot of ups and downs, but this has definitely been my toughest period. I'm absolutely devastated, and it's extremely tough to come to terms with reality at this moment in time. I understand there is gonna be people frustrated, angry, disappointed, and I understand all that. There is no one feeling that more than me at this moment in time. But what I can promise is I will do everything I can to come back better soon to help this club achieve its ambitions this season. Thank you to everyone for the support. It really doesn't go unnoticed, and I really do appreciate it." Meanwhile, it's reported that Real Madrid are reportedly preparing a £50 million bid for Manchester United defender Diogo Dalot in the upcoming January transfer window. The Spanish giants see Dalot as a solution to their right-back issues, especially with ongoing uncertainty surrounding Trent Alexander-Arnold's future plans. Real Madrid have struggled to find a consistent option at right-back this season, and Dalot's performances at Manchester United have caught their attention. The Portuguese international has been a reliable figure at Old Trafford, combining defensive strength with attacking contributions. However, sources from Manchester United have made it clear that Dalot is an important part of Ruben Amorim's plans. The club values his versatility and ability to perform consistently in key matches. Additionally, it is understood that Dalot himself is not looking for a move away. The 25-year-old is believed to be happy at Old Trafford, where he has been playing regularly under Amorim, who recently took charge of the team. United's stand on Dalot? Yes. Manchester United are unlikely to entertain offers for Dalot, especially in the middle of the season. He remains a key player in their bid to achieve success in the Premier League and European competitions. Real Madrid are reportedly monitoring several options, but Dalot appears to be one of their top targets. However, persuading United to sell him mid-season will not be easy. The uncertainty surrounding Alexander-Arnold has added pressure on Real to find a solution, but their pursuit of Dalot may end in disappointment. So, while Real Madrid's interest in Dalot is serious, Manchester United are determined to keep hold of the defender. With Dalot committed to his current club, a January move looks unlikely, leaving Real Madrid to consider other options to fill their right-back position. In other news, Manchester United manager Ruben Amorim has emphasized the importance of unity and equal opportunities in his squad. Speaking about the team's recent performances, he highlighted how giving every player a chance to start has boosted morale. "Imagine how the dressing room feels when everyone has started in the first three games," Amorim said. "They must feel that they are very important to us. That's the message for everyone. We are all together." This approach underlines Amorim's commitment to creating a sense of belonging and togetherness among the players. By involving everyone early in the season, the manager hopes to build a strong bond within the team, which could prove crucial as the season progresses. Meanwhile, Amorim also addressed concerns about Bruno Fernandes' fitness, reassuring fans that the Portuguese midfielder is ready to continue leading the team. "Fernandes has no problem, no injury," Amorim confirmed. "He is a guy who doesn't need a lot of rest, so he is prepared to play again." Bruno has been a key player for United, known for his incredible work rate and leadership on the pitch. Amorim's words will surely ease worries about any potential fatigue or injury for the midfielder, especially during this busy period of fixtures. However, Amorim's statements reflect a refreshing approach at Manchester United, with the manager focusing on teamwork and ensuring every player feels valued. Fans will be eager to see how this philosophy translates into performances on the pitch as United aim for success under their new manager. United's next challenge awaits, and with a United dressing room and players like Bruno Fernandes leading the charge, the team looks ready to push forward. On the other side, Sky Germany reporter Florian Plettenberg claims that United are seriously considering a move for Juventus talent Kenan Yildiz. Plettenberg claims that Yildiz is now one of the top names on United's transfer wish list. It's suggested that United have been impressed with Yildiz's development in Turin and would be interested in signing him at the end of the season. Yildiz is not exactly agitating for a move away from Juve though, and currently feels very comfortable at the club. Convincing the Turkish talent to leave Juventus won't be easy, but United may hope to snatch him away over the summer. News and rumours of United's interest in Yildiz come as speculation over Juventus wanting to sign United's Joshua Zirkzee continues. Juve boss Thiago Motta has dodged questions about Zirkzee, but the interest in Yildiz may spark swap speculation down the line. In other news, Manchester United have been handed two major injury boosts ahead of Wednesday's trip to Arsenal, when Ruben Amorim will look to extend his three-game unbeaten streak. He will have to do so, though, without at least two key men. Both Kobbie Mainoo and Lisandro Martinez will serve a one-match ban after their yellow cards against Everton saw them reach five league cautions. United will cut the gap to the Gunners to 2 points should they win at the Emirates Stadium, with the team only 4 points off the top four despite their poor start to the campaign. And Amorim revealed two significant injury boosts ahead of the clash on Monday. Lenny Yoro, who injured fractured metatarsal. Yoro could make his competitive United debut against Arsenal on Wednesday, with the summer signing set to be part of the squad that takes on Arsenal. He suffered his injury against the Gunners while facing the Gunners over in the US during pre-season. Amorim says he is really excited to utilize the 19-year-old's skill set, but remained cautious about his reintegration. "I think he is a special talent," said Amorim. "We have to be careful in this first moment. We didn't have too many sessions together. He's training with a small group at the moment. He is very good with the ball. I'm really excited. We have to manage the load in the beginning." He expected to come back on Wednesday against Arsenal. Next one is Bruno Fernandes. He injured a foot last Sunday when United against Everton. Fernandes was seen with ice wrapped around his foot and ankle area after being taken off against Everton on Sunday, leading to concern over his left foot. However, Amorim has confirmed the captain is fit to face Arsenal. He remarked, "Fernandes is fit to play. I saw him this morning. He is a guy who doesn't need a lot of rest. He is prepared to play. He expected to come back tomorrow Wednesday against Arsenal. Next one is Johnny Evans. His injury is unknown. Evans has missed the last two matchday squads. On Wednesday, he was given a designated recovery day, but it is not known whether he is carrying anything substantial or if he has simply been omitted by Amorim, who did start him against Ipswich Town on debut. He expected to come back tomorrow Wednesday against Arsenal. Next one is Victor Lindelof. He injured groin. Lindelof has not been seen since hobbling off for Sweden in this month's Nations League fixture with the aid of two medics. Teammates said he looked very down in the changing rooms after full time. United have yet to provide an update on the centre-back, but it is expected that he will be out for a number of weeks. His potential returning dates is unknown. In other news, Manchester United are actively making moves behind the scenes as they prepare for a crucial phase in their development under Ruben Amorim. According to Florian Plettenberg, the club has initiated serious talks about a potential summer move for Viktor Gyökeres, the Swedish striker who has been in excellent form. However, this pursuit comes with complications, as United will need to sell players first to fund the deal. Adding to the challenge, Manchester City have intensified their interest in Gyökeres, with Hugo Viana pushing hard to bring the player to the Etihad. This sets up a fierce transfer battle between the two Manchester giants, with Gyökeres emerging as a priority target for both clubs. Meanwhile, on the contract front, United are making significant strides with Amad Diallo. Fabrizio Romano has reported that the club is close to securing a new long-term deal for the talented winger, aiming to finalize it before the end of 2024. The club views Amad as a key player for the future, and Ruben Amorim is keen to have him as a central part of his plans moving forward. This proactive approach highlights United's determination to retain their most promising assets. In addition to their efforts in the transfer and contract market, Amorim has expressed high praise for young defender Lenny Yoro, calling him a special talent and an ideal fit for a high-pressing system. Amorim described Yoro as a modern defender who excels in one-on-one situations and brings the speed and skill needed to thrive in the Premier League. United are already working on extending Yoro's contract before the current deal expires in 2026, showing their commitment to securing a bright future for the club's defence. These developments underline the ambition of Manchester United's management to build a team capable of competing at the highest level. With key players being tied down to new contracts and strategic moves being made in the transfer market, it is clear that United are taking decisive steps to strengthen their squad and lay the foundation for long-term success. As the summer transfer window approaches, all eyes will be on how these plans unfold and whether the Red Devils can outmaneuver their rivals to secure their top targets. However, the battle for Gyökeres and the focus on locking down talents like Ahmad and Yoro also reflect a broader strategy under Ruben Amorim's leadership. The Portuguese manager is keen to build a squad that not only performs in the present, but is also prepared for future challenges. His emphasis on modern, high-energy football demands players who are technically sound, quick, and adaptable. This approach has already begun to shape the club's recruitment and retention policies, as seen with the targeting of versatile talents like Gyökeres and the long-term planning around players like Ahmad and Yoro. Amorim's vision is clear. Create a squad capable of pressing high, playing fast, and dominating games consistently across all competitions. As the January transfer window nears and the summer looms on the horizon, Manchester United fans can expect more decisive action from the club's management. Whether it's offloading players to make room for signings or doubling down on contract renewals for emerging stars, the next few months will be pivotal. The competition with Manchester City for Gyökeres could set the tone for the upcoming summer window, while securing long-term deals for young talents could solidify the core of United's squad for years to come. With Ruben Amorim at the helm, the Red Devils appear focused and ambitious, aiming to reclaim their position among Europe's elite. In other news, after Manchester United's commanding 4-0 victory over Everton at Old Trafford, Ruben Amorim wasted no time in leading an intense training session as the team prepares for their high-stakes encounter with Arsenal on Wednesday. The session focused on tactical refinement and individual player development, ensuring the squad builds on their recent momentum. One of the standout stories from training was the return of young defender Lenny Yoro, who participated full training today at Carrington under Amorim's meticulous guidance. Yoro impressed with his defensive positioning and quick tackling in small-sided games, signalling his readiness to compete for a starting spot. Marcus Rashford, fresh off an inspiring performance against Everton, continued his excellent form during training. The forward was particularly sharp in finishing drills, consistently finding the back of the net with clinical precision. Rashford's movement and link-up play during attacking patterns demonstrated his growing confidence and readiness to spearhead United's attack against Arsenal. Defensive drills were another major focus of the session. Amorim and his coaching staff emphasized maintaining a compact structure while transitioning quickly into counter-attacks. Players like Harry Maguire, Martinez, De Ligt, Mazraoui, Malacia, Shaw, Dalot, and Lindelof excelled in organizing the backline, while fullbacks worked on overlapping runs and delivering precise crosses. Midfielders were tasked with improving their ball retention and quick distribution under pressure. Bruno Fernandes and Casemiro stood out in Rondo exercises, showcasing their composure and vision. Meanwhile, young talents were also given opportunities to shine, with Kobbie Mainoo drawing praise for his energy and creativity during possession drills, even if he'll miss Arsenal match. Team cohesion and tactical discipline were at the forefront of Amorim's plans. The squad engaged in high-intensity exercises to enhance their pressing and recover the ball swiftly. The session concluded with a full-pitch practice match, where players demonstrated their understanding of Amorim's strategies, particularly in creating overloads and exploiting spaces. As Manchester United head into this pivotal clash, the meticulous preparation led by Ruben Amorim and his staff highlights their commitment to both short-term results and long-term growth. The players are not only sharpening their skills, but also building a unified mentality to face one of the league's toughest opponents. With Arsenal known for their aggressive and high-pressing style, Ruben Amorim ensured his team worked on dealing with pressure in tight spaces. The coaching staff introduced situational drills to mimic Arsenal's fast-paced approach, testing the players' ability to move the ball quickly and decisively. These exercises pushed the squad to think on their feet and maintain composure under duress, qualities that will be critical in Wednesday's encounter. Amorim also paid particular attention to set-piece scenarios, both offensive and defensive. The players rehearsed free-kick and corner routines, with specific focus on exploiting Arsenal's occasional vulnerability in aerial duels. At the other end, the defensive line practiced clearing their zones and staying alert to second balls, ensuring they are well prepared to neutralize any threats. This comprehensive preparation reflects Amorim's determination to leave no stone unturned in the build-up to one of the season's most important fixtures. On the other side, Sheikh Jassim opened to partnership with Ineos for Manchester United ownership, according to report. In a surprising twist, Sheikh Jassim bin Hamad Al Thani has reportedly opened the door to a potential partnership with Ineos to secure majority ownership of Manchester United. This move could see Sheikh Jassim acquiring the Glazers' remaining 44% stake, which would establish him as the club's majority shareholder. Sources indicate that Sheikh Jassim is also considering purchasing the 31% stake owned by minority investors, further consolidating his control over the club. In a bold show of commitment, he plans to finance the construction of a state-of-the-art stadium entirely from his personal wealth, ensuring no financial burden falls on the club. This development comes amid ongoing uncertainty surrounding Manchester United's ownership structure, with fans eagerly anticipating an end to the Glazer family's reign. Sheikh Jassim's willingness to collaborate with Ineos marks a significant shift in his approach, potentially paving the way for a transformative era at Old Trafford. Meanwhile, Manchester United manager Ruben Amorim must make several adjustments to the current squad to make it as competitive as his former Sporting CP team. Harry Maguire faces an uncertain future at Man United, with his contract expiring in June 2025. However, the club have the option to extend it by an additional year. The England international has been injured since the 0-0 draw with Aston Villa in October. He was part of the open training session at Carrington on Wednesday morning, but was not deemed fit for the midweek Europa League clash with Bodo or Glimt. His availability for today's Premier League clash with Everton is still not confirmed. He could be a robust centre-back option for Amorim if he is fit. Maguire could play a vital role in the centre of the three-man defence. Matthijs de Ligt has started both games for Amorim in that role. Given his immense potential and the value he adds, he is expected to remain a mainstay in the lineup. Amorim has emphasized on several occasions that rotation will be crucial to maintaining squad freshness, especially with the demanding schedule ahead. A back three system suits Maguire more than a traditional back four. With two centre-backs alongside him, he doesn't have to cover as much ground and is better shielded from the danger posed by speedy attackers. The £15 million rated star possesses a solid passing range, especially when it comes to delivering long balls from the back. De Ligt lacks this quality, and Maguire could prove to be an asset in involving the wing-backs more effectively in the game. If he can impress Amorim over the next 6 months, United may trigger the option to extend his stay until 2026. In other news, Goodwill Coney, a 16-year-old centre-back from Manchester United's youth academy, is gaining attention as one of the club's brightest young talents. Standing tall at an impressive 196 centimetres, Coney combines physical presence with excellent tackling skills, making him a standout performer in defence. This season, Coney has been instrumental in helping his youth team maintain an unbeaten record in the league, achieving multiple clean sheets along the way. His ability to read the game, intercept passes, and make crucial defensive stops has drawn praise from coaches and teammates alike. Under the guidance of Manchester United's new head coach, Ruben Amorim, Coney's development has accelerated significantly. Known for his trust in young players, Amorim has brought Coney into first-team training sessions to help him adapt to the senior level. These sessions have been crucial for Coney to gain experience, learn from established players, and understand Amorim's tactical style. Amorim's hands-on approach has provided Coney with the confidence to push his limits and aim higher. The coach has reportedly taken a keen interest in mentoring the young defender, offering advice on positioning, timing, and handling pressure during matches. Amorim's support is helping Coney unlock his potential, preparing him for the challenges of top-tier football. Coney's rapid rise hasn't gone unnoticed by fans and pundits. Comparisons to legendary defenders have already begun, with many believing Coney has what it takes to become a future star at Old Trafford. His towering height, calm demeanor, and ability to perform under pressure make him a unique prospect for someone so young. Beyond his physical and technical skills, Coney's maturity on and off the pitch has also impressed. He is known for his strong work ethic and willingness to learn, qualities that align with Manchester United's values of developing disciplined and dedicated players. As Coney continues to grow under Amorim's guidance, fans are eagerly waiting for his senior debut. If given the chance, he could become the youngest defender ever to play for Manchester United, a historic milestone that would cement his place as one of the most exciting prospects in the club's history. Coney's story is also a testament to Manchester United's long-standing tradition of nurturing young talent. Over the years, the club has produced some of the finest defenders in football history, and Coney seems destined to follow in those footsteps. With the club's emphasis on promoting academy players, his progress is being closely monitored by fans and the coaching staff alike. Ruben Amorim's belief in youth development could not have come at a better time for Coney. Amorim's record of fostering young talents during his managerial career suggests that Kony will not just be a part of the squad, but will also have opportunities to prove himself on the pitch. The new manager's tactical vision, which prioritizes a solid defensive setup complemented by quick transitions, suits Kony's natural abilities. His imposing frame and defensive instincts make him an ideal fit for Amorim's plans. Kony's performances in training have already caught the eye of senior players, many of whom have reportedly praised his composure and determination. Having the chance to train alongside experienced professionals like Rafael Varane and Lisandro Martinez is providing him with invaluable insights into what it takes to succeed at the highest level. While the spotlight is firmly on Kony, Amorim is careful to ensure that the young defender is not overwhelmed by the pressure. By managing his exposure and gradually introducing him to competitive football, the coach is setting the stage for Kony to make a meaningful impact when the time is right. This patient and calculated approach is likely to help Kony thrive rather than falter under the weight of expectations. Off the pitch, Kony has shown a level of professionalism that is rare for players of his age. His commitment to training, coupled with a willingness to absorb feedback, reflects his hunger to succeed. He's not just focused on earning his place in the squad, but also on becoming a role model for other young players coming through the academy. As Kony continues his journey, the support from Ruben Amorim, the Manchester United coaching staff, and the fans will be critical. His potential debut in the first team would not only be a personal achievement, but also a signal that United's future remains rooted in its rich tradition of developing exceptional talent. Goodwill Kony is a name Manchester United fans should remember. With his immense talent, strong mentality, and the support of a coach like Ruben Amorim, the future looks incredibly bright for this rising star. He could very well be the cornerstone of Manchester United's defense for years to come.